On behalf of our Viking teammates who finished as Class 1A state runner-ups in 2002, we would like to welcome you to another Mr. K video production of our Viking basketball Road to Glory. As we live the Hoosier dream during the season and tournament play in March of 2002. Let it roll, Mr. K.
Winning seeds and expectations were widespread in Viking country as the season opener with the Washington Hatchets neared. In a preseason comment, Coach Hughes observed, "We have potentially a very versatile team that has good skills at both ends of the court, and we are at least eight players deep." The senior leadership role was ably played by the five seniors, all with some varsity experience, and four returning varsity letter winners. Seniors Brian Cole, Bo Gish, Craig Knapp, Ryan Loniger, Darren Welcher, juniors Zane Bowman, Jason Hawkins, Adam Knapp, Matt Hart, sophomores Bryce Pullock, Tyler Showalter, Kendall Wagner. Varsity coach Brian Hughes was in his 10th year at Barr-Reeve and 17th as a varsity coach. Joe Rademacher, a varsity assistant, was in his 26th year as a teacher and coach at Barr-Reeve. Mark Holt, a junior varsity coach, was in his 19th year as a teacher and 9th as junior varsity coach at Barr-Reeve. Jeff Brookshire, a varsity assistant and freshman coach, was in his 9th year as a teacher and coach at Barr-Reeve. Siobhan Neff, a former Barr-Reeve sports standout, especially in basketball, was a basketball assistant. It was with winning expectations that the Vikings played their season opener the night before Thanksgiving at Hatchet House. Coach Hughes named his opening game starters with seniors Brian Cole, Bo Gitch, Darren Welcher, and juniors Zane Bowman and Adam Ness. The Hatchet lineup included 6'10 freshman Luke Zeller, whose presence would prove to be decisive not only in this game, but for many more Hatchet victories in his career. The Vikings traded back with the much taller Hatchet in the first half of play. Trying to get good percentage perimeter shots or inside scoring would prove to be most difficult against the much taller Hatchet player. The Vikings led 25-24 at the intermission. WHS took an early third quarter lead and went on to post a 57-45 victory. For some Viking faithful, it was a disappointing start. Next up for the Vikings was a trip to Petersburg to take on the Chargers at Pike Central. Senior Craig Neff joined the starting lineup, Cole, Gish, Welcher, and Bowman. Taking the opening tip, the Vikings wasted no time jumping to a 9-2 lead with a combination of three-point shooting, inside scoring, and drive to the basket. However, Pike Central found the range also and fought back to lead the Vikings at half by the score of 29-28. In the second half, the Vikings turned up the defense and turned on the offense with four players in double figures for a 61-47 first win of the season. Darren Welcher grabbed the opening Brian Cole tip and began probing the Bulldog defense. A set play of screens and back cuts found Darren Welcher, getting the Vikings off to a good start with this three-pointer from the top of the key. The Viking lead was 19-10 at the first stop, 24-17 at halftime, 35-21 after three quarters, and cruised to a final of 47-27. Zane Bowman led the Vikings scoring with 18 points and 5 three-pointers. Season and community bragging rights were on the line when the North Davis Cougars came to Viking Country for the annual Buggy Bowl. Darren Welcher took the Brian Cole tip, and the Vikings wasted no time in taking the lead on a Zane Bowman three-pointer. A good scoring first quarter helped the Vikings to a 20-15 first quarter lead, increasing to 36-28 at halftime. The Cougars made a third quarter run, cutting the Viking lead to just 5 points at 46-41 after three quarters. However, strong individual efforts, good team play, and clutch free throw shooting by Bo Gitch and Zane Bowman kept the Cougars at bay for a 61-56 Viking victory. Bowman led the Vikings with 17 points. Darren Welcher with 16. Craig Neff 12 on 4 three-pointers. Bo Gitch 7, Adam Neff 5, and Brian Cole 4. The Viking win was a 26th in the last 28 Buggy Bowl meetings.
Then it's Nick Cross, a nice pass to Zeller for the one-handed flush, and the Hatchets win big tonight, the final 79-46 over South Knox. Not too far from the Hatchet House is Barr-Reeve High School. The Vikings hosting the North Davis Cougars tonight. Lady Viking volleyball team honored before the tip-off, and off the tip, Barr-Reeve would get it done from outside the arc. Zane Bowman knocks down 2 three-pointers back-to-back on his first shot from opposite ends of the floor. But the Cougars would not go away as Jeff Brower runs a two-man game with Adam Trueblood, who gets the lay-in. Then it's Trueblood showing the range from downtown, nailing the three-pointer. But Bowman and the Vikings win the Buggy Bowl tonight down in Montgomery, the final Barry 61, North Davies 56.
A Saturday night journey to Tecumseh to take on the highly regarded Braves would turn out to be a season low point. The Vikings appeared to be on the brink of victory, holding a 44-40 lead with just over a minute to play. A Tecumseh three-pointer and a questionable charging call on the Vikes set the stage for last-second Tecumseh heroics as a foul was called on a rebound scramble, put the Braves on the foul line with a 1-plus. Both free throws were made with just 4 seconds to go, sinking the Viking record and team morale to a season low point. Still stinging from the gut-wrenching loss at Tecumseh, in a week of soul-searching discussions between players and coaches, the Vikes were again on the road facing a tough conference foe at North Knox. Bo Gish got the Vikings off to a good start with a three-pointer on a Darren Welcher assist. But it would be Welcher who would lead the Vikings to victory with a career game of 26 points, followed by Brian Cole with 16. The first quarter was a shooting glimpse, with the Vikings holding a 22-21 lead. Late in the second quarter, Craig Nett found that playing it tough, man-to-man defense can be hazardous to your health in the future. Fortunately, Craig did recover from the intentional foul and managed to hit two of his 10 game points. The Vikings blitzed the Warriors on an 18-4 second quarter run for a 40-25 halftime lead. The Warriors, though, made their second half run pulling within 2 points.
The Warriors playing host to the Barr-Reeve Vikings, and Warrior fans are just falling over for the red and white as J.D. Sossaman, the shake and bake move, gets the jumper to fall. But Barr-Reeve answers as Mabou Gish drives the lane, gets the hard-earned lay-in to go. Warriors back on the attack as Sossaman finds Eric Sanders for the hoop in the lane. But those Vikings are a tough bunch to beat, especially when Darren Welcher scores 26 points. Barr-Reeve winners tonight, the final. Barr-Reeve 74, North Knox 65.
With renewed winning momentum and a 4-2 record, the Vikings now face another tough conference opponent in their gym, the Northeast Du Bois Jeets. Again, it was a combination of good play execution, ball control, and strong individual effort as the Vikings opened a 13-7 first quarter lead, increased to 29-18 at halftime, 47-33 after three quarters, and cruised to a 62-47 conference win. Darren Welcher again led the Viking way, 20-point performance, followed by Craig Nett with 18 and Zane Bowman with 16. Winning momentum had caught hold of the Vikings as they headed for first-round games in the Paoli Classic holiday tournament. Vikings' first opponent in the Paoli Classic holiday tourney was the new Washington Mustangs. The Vikes got off to a slow start, but began to take charge with first quarter scoring contributions from Cole, Welcher, and Gish. Darren Welcher pumped in the first of his game three-pointers. Bo Gish converted this Darren Welcher pass into one of his four first quarter baskets. Vikings led 17-12 at the first stop, 32-22 at the intermission, 51-26 after three quarters, and coasted to a 67-36 victory. Bo Gish and Darren Welcher led the Vikings scoring with 17 points each, followed by Ryan Lonigan with 10. Just 6 hours later, the Vikings took on the Springs Valley Blackhawks in the gym made famous by Larry Bird, otherwise known as Larry Legend. It was three-gola time for Craig Nett and the Vikings. Craig tickled the twine for four first-quarter three-pointers and six for the game. The Vikings had their biggest single quarter of the year as they raced to a 28-8 first-quarter lead on the Blackhawks on the strength of six three-pointers and timely play execution. All 11 players on the Viking roster contributed to the final score as the Vikings coasted to a 77-42 win. Craig Nett led the Vikings with 18 points, followed by Brian Cole with 16. Darren Welcher and Zane Bowman chipped in with 10 each. The victory put the Vikings in the tourney semifinal against tourney favorite and host, the Paoli Rams. Viking record now stood at 7-2 on the strength of four consecutive impressive wins. Not since the regional championship game of 1994 had the Vikings played the Paoli Rams. Then as now, Paoli had all-star caliber players, but then so did the Vikings, and standout players like Darren Welcher, who opened the Vikings scoring with a three-pointer. The Vikings continued to add to their first quarter lead on this drive by Zane Bowman. A turnaround jumper by Brian Coles. Haley was pressing, but a strong individual move by Darren Welcher increased the Vikings lead in the early going. A running floater by Bowman, two of his seven first quarter points. Two free throws by Bo Gidd, or two of his 11 game points. An alert buzzer beater basket by Darren Welcher for his seventh first quarter point, up the Viking lead to 18-13 at the quarter break. The Viking offensive machine produced just 8 second quarter points. Two of them on this Adam Knapp turnaround jumper. With time running out in the second quarter, the Vikes trailing by a single point. Darren Welcher canned this jumper to push the Viking lead into a 26-25 halftime lead. A lead they would keep the rest of the game. The Vikings had managed to play on even terms with the highly regarded KLA team ranked in the top five in Class 2A. 3rd quarter action saw the Vikings getting off to a good start on this perfectly executed back screen baseline lob pass from Bo Gidd to Brian Coles. A Darren Welcher drive and a dish-off pass to Craig Neff in the corner produced the first of 3 second-half Craig Neff three-pointers, keeping the Vikings in the lead. With time running down at the end of the 3rd quarter, Craig Neff took a Darren Welcher pass, drove the left baseline, and canned a jumper to up the Viking lead to 3 points at 44-41 as the 3rd quarter ended. As the 4th quarter got underway, patient Viking offense found Craig Neff pumping in his 3rd three-pointer of the game. Haley All-Star candidate Evan Seacamp had managed only 2 free throws in the first half, but found the range in the 4th quarter, sinking 4 three-pointers to keep his Paoli team within striking distance of the Vikings. Ball control and hitting free throws now became the key to nailing down the Viking victory. Zane Bowman sank 5 of 6 fourth quarter free throws. Bowman led the Vikings in scoring with 17 points, Darren Welcher 12, Bo Gidd and Craig Neff 11 apiece, Brian Cole 8 and Adam Neff 2. It was a classic Viking victory over a tough opponent on their home floor to put the Vikings into the championship game against another 2A powerhouse, the Brownstown Central Braves. It was the first meeting ever between the two schools, who had very similar styles of game and players. Brian Cole tapped the opening tip to teammate Darren Welcher. An out-of-bounds play and an inbounds pass to Bo Gidd got the Vikings on the board with this three-pointer. A scoring drive to the basket by Craig Neff helped the Vikings keep pace with the hot-shooting Brownstown boys. Craig Neff dialed long distance on the first of his game's three-pointers. The first quarter was a scoring clinic as both teams scored early and often. Brian Cole made it look easy as he scored 2 of his 7 first quarter points. Zane Bowman scored the basket and free throw on this baseline floater. time winding down in the first quarter, Zane Bowman canned this runner for two of his seven first-quarter points. Despite the 22-point Viking first-quarter surge, they trailed Brownstown by a single point, 23-22. Viking second-quarter scoring came quickly on a three-pointer by Darren Welcher. A missed three-point shot turns into a rebound basket by Adam Neck. Helped the Vikings to keep up the scoring pace. A nice entry pass to Brian Cole as he again made it look easy for two of his 13 first-half points, five baskets and three of four free-throw shooting. As the half ended, Vikings could manage only a 36-all standoff against the high-scoring Braves of Brownstown. In third quarter action, the Vikings took the lead, thanks in part to 8 points from Brian Cole on two baskets and 4-4 free throw shooting. The Viking lead increased as Bo Gish tossed in a pressure three-pointer from the corner. It would be his last three-pointer of his career. Craig Nett found the same spot on the floor to his liking as he dropped in his second three-pointer of the game to push the Viking lead to 52-46 at the quarter end. Viking fourth quarter scoring continued as Craig Knapp again found the range for his third three-pointer of the game. With the Vikings in the lead and controlling the ball, Brownstown was forced to foul and foul and foul. Craig Knapp hit on four fourth quarter free throws. Zane Bowman, Bo Gish, and Darren Welch also contributed fourth-quarter free throws to close out the Vikings scoring. For the game, Brian Cole led the Vikings scoring with 21 points, followed by Zane Bowman, 17, Craig Knapp, 15, Bo Gish, 9, Darren Welcher, 5, and Adam Knapp, 2. A Brownstown three-pointer at the horn produced a final score of 69-65. It was with a special pride and jubilation that the Viking seniors accepted the tourney championship trophy. Named to the all-tourney team were Craig Knapp, Darren Welcher, and Zane Bowman. Coach Hughes Vikings had impressively established himself as one of the top small school powers in Indiana. Bo's season and high school basketball career, for all intent and purpose, had ended with a torn ACL. However, his Viking teammate's storybook season and tournament play would make it possible for Bowles to score one more career basket as the Vikings played for a state championship in Indianapolis in late March. It is said that one player's downfall or injury is another player's moment of opportunity. Thus it was for Ryan Loniger, Adam Nichols, and Jason Hawkins, who now became an even more important part of the Viking dream season. Playing with renewed determination, three-point shooting, and perfect play execution, the Vikings took a first-quarter lead. Darren Welcher capped first-quarter scoring with this three-pointer that lifted the Vikings to a 19-11 first-quarter lead, increasing to 35-22 at halftime, and an unbelievable 52-28 after three quarters. Darren Welcher led Vikings scoring with 21 points, followed by Zane Bowman and Brian Cole with 16 points each, Greg Knepp, Adam Knepp, and Jason Hawkins all with 6 points each. The victory over always tough and talented Forest Park was not a surprise, but a 30-point lead and a final 71-51 margin of victory certainly was. The final Viking point came at the foul line. Brian Cole capped an excellent performance at both ends of the floor with two of his 16 game points. It was a bittersweet victory as the Viking teammates, coaches, and fans learned to the extent of Bogus' season-ending injury. There was little time to bemoan the loss of Bogus as the WC Cardinals came calling. The Vikings quickly took charge on two first-quarter three-pointers by Craig Knepp and a tray by Jason Hawkins as the Vikings raced by the WC Cardinals 64-31. Craig Knepp led all Vikings scorers with 18 points. The Viking record now stood at 11-2 and 4-0 in conference play as the game of the season with Ligoti was next on the Viking schedule.
That was just one of them games you always mark down on your calendar as being the big game of the year.
Welcome to Super Bowl week on the Martin Davies County line. Saturday night, Barr-Reeve travels to Ligoti.
And Barr-Reeve and Ligoti basketball games are always played with a lot of intensity, a lot of enthusiasm, and a lot of desire on the part of both the players and the fans. And I don't expect this one to be a whole lot different.
However, the 2002 version of the rivalry carries added significance. Barr-Reeve will make the 7-mile journey to the town that Jack built, trying to prevent win number 800.
It'd be a big win for him, and he's an excellent coach, but I'd just rather have him stick on 799 this Saturday.
We've given a few gifts, such as breaking the record last year, and hitting 800 milestone this year would be something that we could give to him as a team.
If you make the trip to the Lions Den this weekend, it might feel like the good old days, when basketball was the only game in town, and heroes were made on the hardwood.
I can remember sitting in the front row, you know, watching the past players play against Barr-Reeve, and it was always, you know, such a thrill. I had all the momentum, the thrills and everything going through my body at the time. It was great.
And it's two small programs that know how to play, and the fans take it very serious, and there'll be a very big crowd there on Saturday.
The second-ranked Vikings and the fourth-ranked Lions in their self-proclaimed Game of the Year.
Yeah, Montgomery, the last one to leave, I'd shut out the lights, but I'm sure it's going to be a packed game over in Ligoti.
Covering basketball as it was meant to be, Jeremiah Johnson, News Channel 2 Sports.
True to all the pregame hype, no game has more bragging rights riding on the outcome than a game with Ligoti. The Lions would take a first-quarter lead of 12-8, a lead they were able to maintain throughout most of the game. The strong inside play of Brian Cole accounted for 10 first-half points, followed by 7 from teammate Darren Welcher. The Vikings trailed 27-22 at halftime and 35-30 after three quarters. But the Vikings began to turn up the defense and turn on the offense. Darren Welcher takes an Adam Knepp fast break pass, scores a no-contact basket to close the margin. Greg Knepp brings the Vikings within two at 37-35 with his 3 points. A breakaway layup by Zane Bowman, but the Lions are still able to maintain their slim lead. Darren Welcher catches in two technical foul free throws to trim the line lead. Craig Knapp again finds the range on a three-pointer to pull the Vikes back within 2 points. Late fourth-quarter free throws by Zane Bowman. And Adam Neck proved to be too little, too late. Ligoti managed to hit 8 fourth-quarter free throws to maintain their margin of victory and break the Vikings' season-winning streak of 8 games and saddle the Vikes with their first conference loss. The Lions held on to win career victory number 800 for legendary Lion coach Jack Butcher. It was a very disappointing conference loss for the Vikings, but did set the stage for the ultimate season game, a sectional rematch, showdown come March. Always a season highlight is the crowning for the basketball queen at homecoming.
The homecoming attendance of varsity cheerleaders, sophomore Reagan Neff, daughter of Richard and Barb Neff. She is being escorted by junior basketball player Adam Neff. Sophomore Whitney Davis, daughter of Larry and Sharon Davis. Junior Melissa Roberts, daughter of Peggy Roberts and Bill Roberts. She is being escorted by junior basketball player Jason Hawkins. Sophomore Alyssa Gregory, daughter of Brian. She's being escorted by junior basketball player Zane
Viking homecoming opponent was the newest conference member, the Wood Memorial Trojans. A familiar Viking scoring start. A Darren Welcher pass to Zane Bowman in three-point territory. Viking center Brian Cole may have missed the queen crowning dunk shot, but he was on target at game time. Another familiar Viking way to score. Darren Welcher nailed a three-pointer to up the Viking lead. Scoring from long range and good play execution such as this helped the Vikings jump to a 20-6 first quarter lead and coast to a 73-41 homecoming victory. Next up was a tough 2A opponent on the road at Eastern Green. Darren Welcher put on the ball handling and scoring clinic as he scored 9 first quarter points and tied his season high of 25 for the game. Zane Bowman chipped in with 6 second quarter points and 14 for the game against the tough Thunderbird defense. However, the Vikes just did not have an answer for Eastern Green's monster man, Clint Burke, as he pushed and shoved his way to a 25-point game. The Vikings did manage a short-lived early fourth-quarter lead, but the Eastern Green boys prevailed 57-51 to deal the Vikings their fourth and final regular season loss. Next stop was a journey to Shoals to take on the Jug Rock. A team Viking teams had an all-time record of 50-5 against. Viking 6'7 center Brian Cole would have a career scoring game as he tossed in 10 first quarter points and 25 for the game. Adam Nepp scored the basket and a free throw in this play. Unfortunately for Adam and the Vikings, these points would be the last in his junior season. He was just minutes away from suffering a season-ending knee injury. The Vikings took a 23-9 first quarter lead and doubled it in the second quarter. Former Jug Rock player Jason Hawkins, now a Viking, scored 5 second quarter points to key the Vikings' scoring surge. The Vikings scored early and often, as all 7 first-half players scored. Ryan Loniger takes an Adam Nepp assist pass and powers in 2 of his 10-game points. In the closing seconds, Adam Nepp drives to the basket. He attempts a jump stop and shot, but his right knee buckles. And Adam goes down in great pain. As Adam was being assisted from the floor, Viking teammates, coaches and fans found it unthinkable that 2 season starters, Bo Gish and now Adam Nepp, were lost within 2 weeks. Trying to stay focused, the Vikings coasted to a 73-51 victory. But again, it was a bittersweet victory. For the second time in season play, the Vikings played the Spring Valley Blackhawks. The Vikings used a 20-7 first quarter surge on lob passes to Brian Cole and 3-point shooting from Ryan Loniger, Craig Nepp, and Zane Bowman to build an early cushion, and went on to defeat the Blackhawks 57-43. Brian Cole paced the Vikings with 19 points to up the Vikings season record to 14-4.
On the line, he had 22 points. Lincoln wins 63-59. Now at South Knox, the host Spartans tangling with the number 3 ranked Barr-Reeve Vikings. South Knox, Nick Lafferty, the up and under scoop shot. Then they gave it to 6'4 senior Tim Lester. He had 17 points, but the bubble would burst for the Spartans thanks to Barr-Reeve's powerful 1-2 punch. James Bowman had 20 points. Then Darren Wilcher from the other side, he had 15. Barr-Reeve 15-4 and 7-1 in blue chip conference play. 61-47 the final.
The conference championship was on the line for the Vikings as they played host to a much-improved Vincennes Reveille Patriot team. We pick up fourth-quarter action. Breaking away from a 38-all tie after three quarters, the Vikings used strong individual moves from Zane Bowman and Darren Welcher. Plus 9 of 10 free throw shooting from Craig Nepp, Brian Cole, Darren Welcher, and Ryan Loniger to pull away from the stubborn Patriots for a 53-46 victory and a share of the Blue Chip Conference Championship with arch rival Lagoda. With the Viking season record at 17-4 and a fourth place rating in Class 1A, WRV came calling to Viking country. The Vikings took an early 11-6 first quarter lead thanks to good teamwork and good post play by Brian Cole as he scored two of his 10 game points. However, it was Darren Welcher who took team scoring honors with his third 25-point game performance of the season, lifting the Vikes to a 48-36 victory over a young and improving WRV team.
We'd like to ask everyone to please stand. Gentlemen, please remove your hats. To honor those who have served our country. Brian Hughes had a prearranged game beginning with Bloomfield coach Ron McBride to give senior Bo Gibbs one last starting role. It was a class act and a very emotional moment for Viking players, coaches, fans, and especially for Bo. As he left the floor to a standing ovation and applause, he received congratulations and hugs from teammates and coaches. However, any thought that Bo would ever again play in another Viking game bordered on a miracle. But thanks to that near miracle, skills of talented teammates, Bo was
Vikings excited about their basketball team. So is Bloomfield. Brian Lengacher, the three-pointer right through the net, and that is the first point of the game. Shot two. Darren Wilcher back with a three-pointer of his own. It's 8-0 Barr-Reeve at that point. Justin Helms getting in the mix with a two-pointer for Bloomfield. Justin Helms one more time from the top of the key, but Barr-Reeve taking out Bloomfield tonight. 46-26. How about that Viking defense? Well, Barr-Reeve and Bloomfield, two teams I just told you down south, people enjoying the outstanding seasons that those teams are having, and we've noticed. That's why we send Action 10 Sports' Mary Jo Perino down to Barr-Reeve tonight. Now, we've all heard the saying, basketball is religion in Indiana. MJP tells me the folks at Barr-Reeve are avid practitioners of that philosophy.
Drew, you want to talk about some diehard fans? Take a little trip down to southern Indiana. Here at Barr-Reeve, they describe basketball in just one word, life.
There's only one place to be in the town of Montgomery on a Friday night. That's in the bleachers. That's a Barr-Reeve gym.
It's crazy. This is, for being in such a small town, everybody's all into the basketball, and, you know, everybody knows everybody, so, of course, it's a big thing here.
It's life. The boys don't play anything but basketball through the summer, and when basketball season comes around, we fill the gym pretty well every game.
These boys are what you call homegrown players. Dad played, maybe even grandpa. And they put a basketball in your hand as soon as you let go of the bottle. That's why they've been so successful here, and the entire community has learned to live for the game.
Oh, heck yeah, I'll go wherever they go. You gotta support them.
I haven't missed a home game in a long time, and I try to hit all the road games, but the sectional is what I live for. That's when it's fun.
A lot of the folks in the crowd tonight are second, sometimes third generation Barr-Reeve Viking basketball players themselves. Maybe that's why, Drew, they haven't had a losing season here since 1976. Reporting from Barr-Reeve for In the Paint, I'm Mary Jo Perino, Action 10 News, WTHI. Drew, back to you.
Yes, always good to see faithful fans practicing the love of basketball. Well,
ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the main event.
The Vikings came into the sectional at Magoti, sporting an 18-4 season record, the best of the six teams to end up in the sectional. The number three ranked Vikings in Class 1A had been ranked in the top 10 all season. It was not surprising then that the Vikings were considered a solid sectional favorite. Unfortunately, the Vikings' successful 18-4 season record had been marred by a pair of season-ending knee injuries to Bo Gitch and Adam Ness, which had left Coach Hughes with a very short bench. The Vikings' first game opponent was a young and improving Vincennes Bay Patriot team that had taken the Vikings to the final minutes of the fourth quarter before bowing 53-46 on the Vikings' home court just 2 weeks prior to the section. Coach Hughes' starting lineup had become a familiar one since early January, consisting of Darren Welcher and Ryan Loniger at the guard, Craig Nipp and Zane Bowman at forward spot, and Brian Cole at center. Craig Nipp took the Brian Cole tip, and the Vikings went on the attack. An entry pass to Brian Cole from Craig Nipp, and Cole gives the Vikings an early lead, a lead they will build on. Zane Bowman tossed in two of his game-high 20 points. Still in first quarter action, Craig Nipp takes advantage of a Ryan Loniger screen to nail a three-pointer. The Vikings lead 13-8 at the end of the first quarter was increased to a comfortable 30-14 halftime advantage. The Vikings put the game out of reach of the Patriots in the third quarter as the lead ballooned 45-20. All Viking roster players were able to contribute to the final 53-27 victory with playing time. The facial expressions and relaxed bench decorum of Viking coaches and players indicated that victory was near.
A Viking victory was not surprising, but the ease of a 26-point margin of victory certainly was. The stage was now set for a Friday night rematch with traditional Viking rival and sectional co-favorite, the number 5-ranked Ligoti Lions, who had defeated Shoal with equal ease. Friday afternoon pep session produced some very spirited cheerleaders in sophomores Evan Hembry and Patrick Delaney as they sought to get the Viking players and student body fired up for the big sectional showdown game with the Ligoti Lions that was just a few hours away. Coach Hughes also had some words of confidence for the Viking faithful.
Chip away, take care of business, and that's what we're hopefully going to do tonight.
In a surprising move, a birthday greeting was extended to the aging one, Mr. Ted. A sectional victory over the Lions would be the perfect birthday present. It was a determined Viking team that took the floor at Jack Butcher Arena to face the Lions. However, there were major obstacles to be overcome. Added to the season-ending loss of Bo Gish and Adam Ness, another Viking player injury now seemed to dim the Viking chances. Standout guard Darren Welcher had sustained a foot injury in the second half of the Vikings' game against Vincennes Bay, and his playing status is now questionable. On the historical side of the Viking-Lion rivalry, Viking varsity teams had not beaten the Goaty on their home floor since the 1985-86 season. However, Viking teams had beaten the Goaty for sectional championships in 1987, 92, 94, 97, and 1999. Bo Gish and Adam Knepp had become inspirations to their teammates. But perhaps it was Bo's emotional note to his teammate on game day that sparked the special determination to win this game.
You guys have a chance. A chance to do something a lot of people don't get to do. If you only knew what it felt like to not be able to battle on that floor and make a difference, or be some kid's hero because you did something great. Early in the season, Jack got his 800th win against the Vikings. But you boys have a chance to end the season, he got his 800th. People in Montgomery will remember that. You can't go back and change this. So play as hard as you can for your parents, your coaches, your fans, your teammates, for yourself. And oh yeah, Zane, you're not playing the Lions.
With the opening kick, it was now time to lay aside all the pregame hype and just make history. Craig Nett got the Vikings on the board with this 3-point toss. In first quarter play, the Lion defense limited the Vikings to perimeter shots, but Zane Bowman found the range as he knocked home his second three-pointer of the quarter and 9th point of the game. Sparked by Kevin Lannon's 12 first quarter points, the Lions held a 16-14 first quarter lead. In second quarter action, Darren Welcher slipped a baseline pass to back-cutting Zane Bowman, who weaved his way through the Lion defense for two. The Lions' Kevin Lannon was nearly unstoppable at his end of the floor. He hit for two of his 16 first-half points. Zane Bowman answers with a three-pointer for three of his 14 first-half points. With the score tied at 21-all and more than 4 minutes remaining in the half, Lion coach Jack Butcher decides to just hold on to the ball. Viking coach Brian Hughes also decides to play the waiting game. At his center, Brian Cole is on the bench with two fouls, and hot-handed Zane Bowman is on the floor with two fouls. The Lions do get the last shot, but come up empty as both teams head to the locker room with the score knotted at 21-0. A game turning point happened on the first possession of the third quarter. The Vikings' Darren Welter makes a perfect lob pass to Zane Bowman, who connects for two of his 8 third quarter points. The Vikings take the lead for good. Still in third quarter and leading, the Vikes look to get some inside. Still in third quarter and leading, the Vikes look to get the ball inside. A perfect entry pass from Zane Bowman to Brian Cole increases the Viking lead. The Vikings increase their lead to 31-26 as the third quarter ends, but Coach Hughes reminds his players there is still a long way to go. We move to fourth quarter action as the Vikings are executing their own version of ball control, much to the dismay of Coach Butcher. The Lions are forced to foul for ball possession. Craig Knepp nailed 4 of 4 fourth quarter free throws and 6 of 6 for the game for a total of 9 game points. The concerns for Darren Welcher's injured right ankle seem to be forgotten as the Viking lead continues to increase with impressive free throw shooting. It seemed that all the frustration that Zane Bowman had endured in previous games against the Goaty was exorcised this night. Zane connected on 7 of 8 fourth quarter free throws and 10 of 11 for the game. Junior Jason Hawkins was put at the foul line as the Lions made a last gasp run at the Vikes. But Jason responds by hitting both free throws to keep the Lions at bay. Senior Ryan Loniger also responded with a free throw scoring opportunity. The Viking student body and adult faithful could sense that victory was within their grasp. The horrors and frustrations for our Viking teams in Jack Butcher Arena were about to become past history. Celebration time was nearing as Zane Bowman capped a career performance with his 11th field goal of the game. Darren Welcher tossed in 3 of 4 fourth quarter free throws. For the game, the Vikes converted 22 of 25 free throw attempts. It was hard to believe the Vikings were just seconds away from taking a huge step towards a sectional championship. Perhaps it was only fitting that Zane Bowman would score the final Viking game point. A final desperation shot by Kevin Lannan was off its mark, and it was a 54-47 Viking celebration and jubilation moment for Viking players, coaches, and fans. As the passing months would reveal, for Lagodi Lion coaching legend Jack Butcher, this was the final game of his 45-year history-making and record-setting career. With the completion of post-game handshakes, hugs, and good luck wishes, the Viking players and coaches retired to their dressing room for their own post-game team rituals and player reminders.
Well, Jason, all it takes is one trip to a Barr-Reeve Lagoda game to see how special and intense the rivalry is. The Lions won the regular season game. It was the 800th win for Jack Butcher. But tonight, the only thing that mattered, moving on in the state tournament, the Jack Butcher Sports Arena filled to the brim. The Lions hold the ball the final 3.5 minutes of the second quarter with the game tied at 21. The Vikings say go right ahead. In the third quarter, have a great start. Darren Wilcher alley-oop to Zane Bowman. Then the Vikings pounded inside to big Brian Cole, 6-7 with some moves. The Lions rely on their big guns. Allen burst for three, then fellow senior Kevin Lannon. 29 points for Lannon, great performance. But the night belonged to Zane Bowman. 35 points, big-time game and a big-time rivalry. Coach Bryant uses his troops move on to fight another day. The final, 54-47.
We got to come back down on earth in the morning, and we'll be ready for the winner of this next game. But my kids, I thought really, you know, what's happened to us this year with the injuries, and our kids really battled and played hard, and I was just, I'm so excited for Zane Bowman. He's struggled against his old teammates, and coming out here at 35 is just a great effort.
Still basking in the afterglow of a history-making 54-47 sectional win over Lagoda, the Vikings took the floor at Jack Butcher Arena to face yet another challenging rival, the North Davis Cougars. The Vikings were now a strong favorite to win the sectional, but the Cougars, led by all-area top gun Adam Trueblood, had had an underachieving season and were very capable of derailing the Vikings. Greg knocked home two of his three free throws. In the closing minute of the first quarter, the Vikes were trailing 4-2. Again, the Vikes go inside to Brian Cole. The shot does not go down, but Brian does get the call this time.
Substitution for North Davies, number 32, Brandon Callison. And for Barr-Reeve, number 20, Brian Lonegan.
Cole will hit both free throws. Tie the score at 4-4 as the quarter ended. We move to second quarter action. Darren Wilson had been nursing a very painful foot injury, but he showed little ill effect as he elevated for his patented fadeaway jumper to give the Vikings the lead. Late in the second quarter, Zane Bowman three-pointed, and Jason Hawkins cashing in two free throw opportunities keep the Vikings in the lead at halftime by the score of 11-10. By halftime, it was now evident this was going to be a checker game to the final buzzer.
Going weak, reverse this. Weak, reverse.
No! Come on now!
Take your shot now!
Bring back!
The score scoring pace picked up in the third quarter. Brian Cole hit two free throw attempts to increase the Viking lead to 3 points at 13-10. A Viking special, a backdoor lob pass from Darren Welcher to Zane Bowman kept the Vikings in the lead. But Cougar standout Adam Trubler was keeping his team close with 11 third-quarter points. Zane Bowman tossed in this three-pointer for three of his seven third-quarter points. Darren Welcher did not always need a special play to score. Sheer athletic ability. Still in third quarter action, Darren Welcher drives hard left, tosses the ball to teammate Craig Neff, who drains the three-pointer from the corner to close out Viking scoring in the third quarter. Keeps the Viking team in the lead at 25-23. In early fourth quarter action, with the score tied at 25-all, a missed shot by Brian Cole is rebounded by Craig Neff for a basket to give the Vikings a 27-25 lead. The Cougars had managed to tie the score at 27-all. Brian Cole, being closely guarded, hit a short jumper to put the Vikings on top, 29-27, with just 2:10 remaining. A North Davis miss gives the Vikings ball possession. With just 28 seconds showing, Craig Neff hits not one but two of the biggest free throws of his high school career, lifting the Vikings to a 31-27 lead, but the Cougars were not yet finished. With just seconds remaining, the North Davis basket and two missed one-and-one free throw opportunities by the Vikings had created the opportunity for last-second heroics for the Cougars. It was the Cougars' ball out with just 2.8 seconds showing. For the Vikings, it was going to be overtime, instant defeat, or a sectional championship. An inbound pass to Cougars' Cole Raber. He drives across midcourt.
Today I live, I want to be a day to give the best of me. I'm only one, but not alone. My finest day is yet unknown. I broke my heart for every game. Taste the sweet, I face the pain. I rise and fall, yet through it all, this must remain. No.